Students, welcome back. Today we will study about the symmetrical T network. So in a symmetrical T network there are two arms. One is called as the series arm and other is called as the shunt arm. So in this symmetrical T network there is a condition that the series arm and the shunt arm impedances should be Z1 and Z2 respectively. So we will see how this will be in the T network. Suppose we are having a T network drawn like this, symmetrical T network. This is a T network having a series arm. This is called as a series arm, and this one is called as a shunt arm. If you have like these two arms, this one total is called as a series arm. This one is called as a shunt arm, and here you are having 1 and 1 dash, and here it is 2 and 2 dash respectively. In this T network, this is called as a symmetrical T network. In a symmetrical T network, it should be such that the series arm impedance as well as shunt arm impedance should be Z1 and Z2 respectively. So what we do is, for series arm impedance we will do here Z1 by 2 and Z1 by 2, and this one is the only Z2. So like this you can write here Z1 by 2, here it is Z1 by 2 and it is Z2. So series arm impedance will be Z1 by 2 plus Z1 by 2 is equal to Z1, and here it is Z2 only. So for a symmetrical T network, as I have said, that Z1 and Z2 should be the arm impedances of the T network. So here the series arm impedance is Z1 and the shunt arm impedance is Z2 respectively. So that is a condition. That is a condition for a symmetrical T network. Z1 and Z2 should be the arm impedances. Z1 is the series impedance, that is Z1 by 2 plus Z1 by 2, that is equal to Z1, and this Z2 is equals to shunt arm impedance. Like this, if you are having this T network which is having the impedances Z1 by 2, Z1 by 2 and Z2 here, this total together is a single arm only. This total together is a single arm which is having impedance Z1. This is a single arm, that is shunt arm impedance having Z2. Now we will go for the, we are to derive the characteristic impedance. As you have studied about the characteristic impedance in the previous class, that is, it is defined by Z0. So Z0 is the characteristic impedance. So we will, let us derive now what is Z0, characteristic impedance Z0. Okay. The characteristic impedance can be derived in two ways, that is, we are having the characteristic impedance called as Z0, and this can be derived in two ways. The first one is, you can in terms of the impedances series and shunt arm impedances, series and shunt arm impedances, and second is in terms of open circuit and short circuit impedances. So first we should draw a T network for this. If you are drawing a T network like this, symmetrical T network, you have to draw that will be having the two ports, 2 2 dash 1 1 dash here, and that is the Z in input, and here Z1 by 2, it is Z1 by 2 series arm impedance, and Z2 is the shunt arm impedance, and here we are terminating the output terminal with characteristic impedance Z0. This is the Z0. Now, how to find out the value of Z0? How to derive the value of Z0 is important. In a symmetrical network, when we are terminating a two-port network with the Z0, terminating means we are just making that particular point here 2 and 2 dash with the Z0. We are connecting it here. So, if you are connecting Z0 here, then this is called as a symmetrical T network. Symmetrical T network terminated in Z0. In Z0. So, this is the figure of the symmetrical T network terminated in Z0. So, this is here in the output terminal, we are terminating it with Z0. We are nothing but making this branch or making this impedance added here. So, according to the property of symmetry, as we have studied the property of symmetry, that the output impedance should be equal to the input impedance. Output impedance should be equal to the input impedance. That means that if Z0 is here, that should be equal to input impedance. So, we can write here Z in is equals to Z0. So, Z in is equal to Z0, nothing but Z0 is the characteristic impedance, and we will derive the characteristic impedance here. So, Z in is equal to Z0 now. So, we are having Z0 here, and from Z0 or Z in, we call it as the same, Z in is equal to Z0 only. According to the symmetrical T network or property of the symmetry, property of the symmetrical T network also we can say, due to the property of symmetrical T network, Z in is equal to Z0. So, both sides should be the same, input impedance should be Z0, output impedance should be Z0, then only it is called as symmetrical. Symmetrical means of, if it is one side the same, the second side also should be the same thing here. So, it is called as symmetrical network, symmetrical T network. Okay, Z in is equals to Z0 here, and we will derive the Z0 equation. How to derive the Z0 equation means you have to go for the this solving of this particular circuit here. If you are solving this particular circuit, then you can easily find out what is Z0. So, here Z1 by 2 is the first impedance here. After that, we are having here Z2, Z1 by 2 and Z0. So, if they are series or they are in parallel, we will see first, and then we will be making this particular network solved here. Okay, seeing here Zin is equal to Z0, Zin is equals to Z0 is equals to, what is that? Zin is equal to Z0 is equal to Z1 by 2 plus Z1 by 2 plus Z1 by 2 plus Z2 parallel to Z2 parallel to Z1 by 2 plus Z0, Z1 by 2 plus Z0. Okay, because Z1 by 2 and Z0 are in series here, and this is Z2 is parallel to them, we can write like this, Z2 parallel to Z1 by 2 plus Z0. So, we can treat it other thing, this is one entity and Z2 is one entity here. So, we can say Z1 by 2 plus Z2 parallel to Z1 by 2 plus Z0 as it in series. Now, we will do Z0 is equals to, we will solve the equation Z0 is equals to Z1 by 2 plus Z2 parallel to Z1 by 2 plus Z0, Z1 by 2 plus, how we will write this equation, Z2 into Z1 by 2 plus Z0 R1 R2 by R1 plus R2 form, Z2 plus Z1 by 2 plus Z0 R1 R2 by R1 plus R2 form. So, this remains the same, Z1 by 2 remains the same here, Z1 by 2 plus is equal to Z0. Okay, this equation is the equation what we, when now we have to solve this equation. After getting that equation, how we have to solve is Z0 into Z0 into Z2 plus Z1 by 2 plus Z0, we are sending this one here, this side. So, it is equal to, now, so multiplying this one is equal to, so here also we have to multiply Z1 by 2 into Z2 plus Z1 by 2 plus Z0. Okay, so we will completely write this from here. Once again, you will write here Z0 is equals to Z1 by 2 into Z2 plus Z1 by 2 plus Z0, this is one bracket, plus Z2 into Z1 by 2 plus Z0, this is other one, divided by Z2 plus Z1 by 2 plus Z0. So this one you have multiplied this one here, and plus you have written the same thing, divide whole divided by, you have written Z2 plus Z1 by 2 plus Z0 is a denominator. Now this is the right hand side you are having Z0. Now we will do this accordingly, we will be doing this one. Now we have to cross multiply this one, Z0 into this particular thing and Z1 by 2 here. So it is 1, so we will cross multiply it. Z0 is equals to Z2 into Z1 by 2 plus Z0 is equal to Z1 by 2 into Z2 plus Z1 by 2 plus Z0 plus Z2 into Z1 by 2 plus Z0 into 1. After cross multiplication, Z0 into Z2 plus Z1 by 2 plus Z0 is equal to Z1 by 2 into Z2 plus Z1 by 2 plus Z0. Z1 by 2 plus Z0 plus Z2 into Z1 by 2 plus Z0. That equation we are writing here. Okay. Now you can write here Z0 into Z2 plus Z1 by 2 plus Z0 is equal to Z1 by 2 into Z2 plus Z1 by 2 plus Z0 plus Z1 Z2 by 2 Z plus Z1 Z2 by 2 plus Z2 Z0. So this one we have got that equation as we have opened the brackets and we have written the same step here, Z1 by 2 into the same that we repeated. Now therefore what we can write here is multiply this one, open the brackets, Z2 Z0 plus Z1 Z0 divided by 2 plus Z0 square is equals to Z1 Z2 by 2, Z1 Z2 by 2 plus Z1 square by 4 plus Z1 Z0 by 2, okay, plus Z1 Z0 by 2 plus remaining thing Z1 Z2 by 2 plus Z2 Z0. After getting this one, we can write now Z0 square common, we can take this, here some part will be cancelled, this is equal to here Z0 into Z2 plus Z0 Z1 by 2 plus Z0 square is equal to this one. Here let us cancel some terms, Z1 Z0 by 2 gets cancelled, Z2 Z0 gets cancelled, as well as here you are having Z0 square only, and this here you are having three terms. Here we are having how many terms here? Z naught z1 square by 4 plus z1 z2 by 2. So we can write here 2 z1 z2 by 2 plus z1 square by 4. So it will be 2 2 gets cancelled. Z1 z2 plus z1 square by 4. That means that z0 square is equals to z1 z2 plus z1 square by 4. So here after removing the root we get here square root of z1 square by 4 square by 4 plus z1 z2. Here z1 and z2 are nothing but the impedances, series arm impedance and shunt arm impedance z1 z2. So the characteristic impedance in terms of the series arm impedance as well as shunt arm impedance is derived here. So we can say that the characteristic impedance in terms of z0 is equal to z1 square by 4 plus z1 z2 under root. So this is the characteristic equation. Now we will go for the in terms of the open circuit and short circuit impedances. Now the calculation of the characteristic impedance in terms of open circuit and short circuit impedance One thing what we have to remember in this symmetrical network is if you are measuring the open circuit volt impedance or the short circuit impedance from any of the terminals, suppose you are having a pair of terminals 1-1 dash and 2-2 dash. So if you are measuring from 1-1 dash or 2-2 dash also, the open circuit impedance will be of the same value in symmetrical networks. In symmetrical networks, the impedance measured, open circuit impedance measured from 1-1 dash or 2-2 dash will be the same. So we can write it in mathematical form like this. Suppose you are having here, so you can write here for symmetrical network, the impedance measured, at any pair of terminals, by open circuiting or short circuiting, will have the same value, Now we will draw one symmetrical network for that purpose. Suppose we are having one symmetrical network like this, symmetrical T network. As you are studying about the symmetrical T network, we will draw a symmetrical T network here like this. And if you have this symmetrical T network, Z1 by 2 is the series arm impedance and this is the series arm impedance. And here it is Z2 is the shunt arm impedance, 1-1 dash, and it is 2-2 dash. Now this is open circuit from both sides, this side and this side. There is no connection here. So if you are measuring the impedance from this side or you are measuring the impedance from this side, then the both the impedance will be the should be the same according to the symmetrical T network. Symmetry means what we have to have on the right hand side and the left hand side should be equal only. Now we will see that if you are calculating ZOC open circuit impedance, as we have to derive the open circuit impedance in terms of open circuit and short circuit impedance, we have to derive the characteristic impedance. ZOC is equal to ZOC1. This is called as ZOC1 and Z1OC or Z2OC. Why? Because this is, if you measure from this side or this side, if you are measuring the impedance, then it will be the same only as it is having symmetry. The middle one is there and you are having symmetry on both sides. the same value will be there, impedance value. Okay, this is called as symmetrical T network, symmetrical open circuit impedance. So open circuit impedance ZOC is equal to Z1OC is equal to Z2OC. Now we will go for the open circuit first and later on go to the short circuit. Now we will keep this figure open circuit and go to the short circuit later, and we will go for the characteristic impedance by using both open circuit impedance and short circuit impedance. Now we will see here this network we are drawing. Suppose you are having like this. This is the network. It is Z2, Z1 by 2 and Z1 by 2 here. It is 1 dash. It is 2 dash. This is A. This is for open circuit. Open circuit impedance. This is for open circuit impedance. Now we will name it as open circuit impedance for symmetrical T network. Symmetrical T network. Okay, let's begin now. So from this figure A, what you are having? We are having here Z1OC is equal to Z2OC is equal to ZOC. Therefore, what you have to do here is you are having Z1OC is equal to Z2 is equal to ZOC. So ZOC is equals to, this is Z1 by 2, this is also Z1 by 2. So it is Z2 here. If you calculate from this side, if it is open circuited, then this higher current doesn't flow. Current doesn't flow means we can neglect this part of the impedance and only we can calculate Z1 by 2 plus Z2. Z1 by 2 plus Z2. We will neglect this complete branch because no current is flowing. If no current is flowing, we cannot have this particular branch itself. We are only calculating the branches which are having the current flow in it. When it is short circuited, the current can flow here. There is a path for the current to flow. But here the path is not there. So this branch can be left out. This branch can be left out then if this is open circuited. Okay. Now if you are going from this side, if this side it is having Z1 by 2 plus Z2. Z1 by 2 plus Z2. Here also the same thing. If you are having from this side 1 dash. If 1 dash is there, if the current is not flowing there in this particular branch, then we can take from Z1 by 2 plus Z2. So ZOC is equal to Z1 by 2 plus Z2 for either you are taking from this side or you are taking from this side. If you are taking from this side, open circuiting from this side, this one will become 0. If you are open circuiting from this side, this Z1 by 2 becomes 0 and total impedance will be the series of these two combinations. So ZOC is equal to Z1 by 2 plus Z2. Okay, now we will go for other figure, that is a short circuit impedance. How to draw that short circuit impedance? So if you are having this circuit, the same circuit here, we are redrawing and we will be having this circuit here. This is a T network. Short circuit impedance. And here it is short circuited. Short circuit means only connecting a wire here. Z1 by 2, Z1 by 2 and Z2. This remains the same. And this is ZSC. ZSC is nothing but the short circuit impedance that is to be calculated for this particular network. Okay, how to calculate this ZSC? If we name it as here equation number 1, it will be beneficial. So if ZOC is equal to Z1 by 2 plus Z2, Z1 by 2 plus Z2 is the equation number 1. Now we will derive the short circuit impedance for this one. So we will see here Zsc is equals to Z1sc is equal to Z2sc. If we short circuit this side or this side also, it is both are the same things in a symmetrical network. So we will write that particular thing here. If it is short circuited this here, if it is short circuited this particular thing, then what we can write is here Z1 by 2 is in series and these are in parallel, plus Z1 by 2 parallel to Z2. This is the short circuit impedance. You can try this way also, because the symmetrical network is there, both the answers will be the same thing. Okay, Z1 by 2 plus Z1 by 2 parallel to Z2. So you can write here Z1 by 2 plus, you can write Z1 Z2 by 2 R1 R2 by R1 plus R2. Z1 by 2 plus Z2. Z1 by 2 plus Z2. This is the form you got. This is one total entirety and this is the separate one. That is equal to Z1 by 2 plus, that is equal to ZS. Now we have to use this formulas, ZSC formulas, and derive the actual value of the, in terms of the characteristic impedance. So we got ZSC as well as we got the ZOC. Now after simplification we can write the ZSC, and therefore we can make this ZOC and ZSC in terms of Z0, in terms of Z0, that is the characteristic impedance. Okay, we will proceed now. So ZSC is equals to, by cross multiplying this one, Z1 by 2 into Z1 by 2 plus Z2 plus Z1 Z2 by 2 whole divided by Z1 by 2 plus Z2, Z1 by 2 plus Z2. Okay. Now if you are opening this bracket, Z1 square by 4 plus Z1 Z2 by 2 plus Z1 Z2 by 2 divided by Z1 by 2 plus Z2. Okay. Now it is Z1 square by 4 plus Z1 Z2. These both will become Z1 Z2 divided by Z1 by 2 plus Z2. Therefore, we have here ZSC is equals to Z1 square by 4 plus Z1 Z2 divided by Z1 by 2 plus Z2. And we will mention it as equation number 2. As we have already derived the equation number 1, the equation number 1 was about ZOC. So we will write about ZOC. ZOC is equals to Z1 by 2 plus Z2. Already we have derived this one ZOC equation and named it as equation number 1. So this was ZOC is equation number 1 and is equation number 2. Now after getting this equation number 1 and equation number 2, what you have to do is we have to now multiply this 1 and, so multiplying this 1 and 2 equations, ZOC into ZSC is equals to Z1 by 2 plus 2, it is ZOC, and what is ZSC? Z1 square by 4 plus Z1 Z2, Z1 square by 4 plus Z1 Z2 divided by Z1 by 2 plus 2. So here this gets cancelled. And ZOC ZSC is equals to Z1 square by 4 plus Z1, Z2, and therefore you are getting this ZOC into ZSC. But what is Z0? Z0 is equal to square root of Z1 square by 4 plus Z1 Z2. So this was the characteristic impedance already we have derived. Now we have, what we had, the same thing is here. So what you can write here, ZOC is equals into ZSC is equals to Z0 square, and Z0 is equal to square root of ZOC into ZSC. So characteristic impedance in terms of the open circuit impedance and short circuit impedance is derived here. So you can equate it as an equation number 3 here. So this is Z0, because Z0 is equal to square root of Z1 square by 4 plus Z1 Z2. Since this term is important, since Z0 is equal to square root of Z1 square plus Z1 Z2, we are replacing this one by Z0 here. So it is under root. So it is not, it's under root here. So we can do square here. Z0 square is equals to, the square of bracket will be removed. Therefore, Z0 square is equal to ZOC into ZSC. So the characteristic impedance in terms of this particular thing is derived here. So students, I want to end the class here, and in the next class we will deal about the propagation constant. Thank you.